Hi everyone, my name is Esther and this is part 3 of the tiny mini-series The Relationship with Jesus Christ. As before I start, as always, this is the Word of God and with this, truly a change is gonna come if you read it. It is not a lie, if you read it, please read it and a change is gonna come. So, that being said, this is part 3 of the tiny mini-series Relationship with Jesus Christ. And today I want to discuss, I want to talk about how God sees us in this relationship. Yesterday and the day before I talked about what our perspective are from this relationship and how we need to see this relationship. But today we're going to discuss about you and about me and how God sees us. Because when he sees me, he sees you as well. Because we are the same. We are both human. And this is not only for me, or only for you, or only for some people somewhere on the world. No, this is for everyone. Because we are made in his image. We are his being. We are created by him. So, that being said, the first thing I want to discuss is that he loves us. He loves us so much that even while we were sinners without Christ, and we were living without Christ in our life, he loved us. So before Jesus Christ died on the cross, he already loved us. That's huge. So that means that you and I can do nothing about this love. Because he already loved us before Jesus died on the cross. So after Jesus died on the cross, he still loves us. I will back this up with scripture, of course. In Romans 5, verse 8, but God commanded his love toward us, you and me, toward us, that in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. That is amazing. That is huge. That's really huge. So he loves us. And this is something you need to say to yourself many, many times, because I know too many Christians and people who are not Christians, they can tell all day long how bad they are, what is wrong with them, how wrong is their character, how many sins they have, and how wrong they are. But if they ask him, well, do you know how God sees you? Do you know that you are the righteousness of God in Christ? That is amazing. And unfortunately, I do not have enough time to talk about the subject of righteousness, but I will make a series of it because it is the most important thing. It has totally changed my life. We have right standing with the Lord. We are his righteousness. He made us, when we come to Christ and we have a relationship with him and we confess with our mouth, yes, he is Lord, he is the Son of the living God, he died on the cross for us as a sacrifice, and after 3 days he rose up again, the first man who conquered death, and is now alive with God on his right hand, on his right side. That means that I have a right standing with him. And so too many people have sin consciousness. They know so much about how wrong they are. But we need to know righteous consciousness. We need to get these facts. And before somebody will say, I am the righteousness in God, what? This is not something that I make up. I will speak out loud in scripture. 2 Corinthians 5, verse 21. And it says, For he had made him, Christ, so God had made him, Jesus, to be sin for us. Jesus, who knew no sin, that we, you and I, might be made the righteousness of God in him. So I am the righteousness of God. I can approach God without being terrified or being a frightened chicken which stays in the cabin and not coming out. We can approach God because he loves us. And he not only loves us because he knows that we will mess up every time, big time. just as Adam and Eve did in the Garden of Eden. And they were just like you and me. So God knows these people will mess up anyway. So let impart us. So that you and I are a new person in him. That we are the righteousness in Christ for God. So that is amazing. Sorry, I just want to say so much about the subject. But as I said before, I don't have the time right now in this series. Because this is a tiny series about the relationship of Jesus Christ. But this is something you need to know. And next is in Ephesians 6. In Ephesians 6, a lot of Christians will know this scripture. This is all about, especially from verse 10, it's all about spiritual warfare. And I know a lot of Christians, there are spiritual warfare all day long. They are fighting demons, they are doing this. And I'm not saying that it is not correct. Please do not, because it's important to have spiritual warfare. But what I believe, that spiritual warfare need to be put in place. Because spiritual warfare is the last thing spoken of in chapter 6 of Ephesians. And Paul, who wrote these letters, wrote chapter 1, 2, 3, and so on, till he came to chapter 6. And then he says in verse 10, I will do it by my heart. Dus, I don't know it correctly. I will find out. I will check it out if it's verse 6 or not. It will say, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. That is verse 10. Yes, it says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord in the power of his might. And then he goes on with all the the armor we need to get. The shield of faith, the sword of the word. The word is the sword which you can battle with. But do you know chapter 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? Do you know what stands in chapter 1? The most important scripture from the whole chapter. And in chapter 1, it says all about that we are the children of God. That he sees us as children. And I don't know if you have children, but and can you just imagine that you have a child and your child is crawling down the ground and is asking you, well, can I have this, please? I'm begging you. I think you will slap him, but not a hard slap, of course, but a slap of love. And saying, please, act normal. What is this? Why are you approaching me? And I believe that God is saying today the same. Why are you approaching me not with boldness? And as his word says, that we can approach him in boldness. Because we have a right standing with him. We are the righteousness in him. That is amazing if you think about it. So, these are the few highlights of how God sees you and sees me. He loves us so much that he made us the righteousness in Christ. And we can approach him because we are his children. So we can approach him with boldness and with love. We can have this relationship. So this is for today, and see you tomorrow for the last part already. Okay, see you, bye.